military conflict, there is a big difference between a ceasefire and a capitulation. A capitulation is when one of the warring parties gives up. A capitulation often leads to the end of the conflict. In an armistice, the conflict is ended because all parties agree that this is going nowhere. An armistice, however, is not something that's that common. A capitulation can happen formally by countries saying, okay, we give up, or it can happen informally when it's obvious that fighting has no use. The United States of America capitulated in Vietnam, even though they will never say it like this because then it would imply that they need to accept defeat. So they don't call it that way. Now, we know that all wars are hoaxes, so all those conflicts have been prearranged by the Apollonians. Now, I've also explained that the only real war that's going on the earth now is the war against Christ and his rule. And that all human conflict on the earth is a reflection of this resistance against God's sovereignty. So, seeing it from this angle, we as believers need to understand that there's only one kingdom, that's the kingdom of Christ, and then you have the powers of darkness who operate in the negative. The powers of darkness, you can call them the paranormal or the demonic realm, they feed off of human energy. And from the human population, you have the majority that aligns themselves with the powers of darkness. Many do it because they don't know any better, they're threat, and there is a minority of the human species that knows very well what's going on, and they persist in darkness because they hate the light. They hate the fact that Christ is God and that nobody can defeat him. They hate the fact that they live on the earth, which is God's house, and that they have no other option. So those people know very well that there is no winning against resisting Christ, and because of that, they're losing their minds. Now, as a believer, you need to understand the following. When you walk by faith and you successfully shake off the violence of the world around you, what is going to happen? You will have worldlings that will experience the power you walk in, and they'll realize that, oh, there is a big power behind you. And those worldlings will sooner or later figure out that it's Christ. And they realize the truth of the matter. And those people will join the kingdom of God. They will become born again. But then you'll also have worldlings that will experience the power they will experience the power you walk in. But in a very uncomfortable way, they will experience the power when things backfire on them. For example, people decide that they can't stand you. Why? Because they don't want to face themselves. And for some reason, they expect you to take their victimization so they are at ease. And they make actions against you openly and publicly. And now in private, things are backfiring. So now publicly, they need to take back their words and their actions. But they can't do it. Because if they take back their words and actions, everyone's going to ask why. And then you need to explain that things are backfiring. And if things are backfiring, you need to admit that there's some power behind you that you can't defeat. And they need to admit that they are defeated. They don't want this. They have to go against their own relief seeking. And this is something they absolutely don't want to do. But if they have no other option, they are stuck. And when they are stuck, frustration will build up and things will escalate. They'll turn on each other like madmen and madwomen. Men, women. So, that is why, as a believer, you will experience a ceasefire by the world. When the world around you realizes that acting against you or sabotaging you simply will not work, they will come with a ceasefire. Suddenly, people know how to treat you well. Suddenly, they know how to apologize. Suddenly they know how to do all the right things. And then you ask yourself, okay, but if you know how to do the right thing, why didn't you do it years back? Why? Because things backfired on them. And behind the scenes, they have suffered losses. Some of them lost their minds and rage against their children. And now their children don't want to see them anymore. Others lost their jobs because at the job, they acted out against a fellow employee. And the boss thought, okay, I can't have you here. Some lost their companies because they, as the bosses of the company, took out their anger against you on their coworkers. And because of that, customers saw it. Customers thought, I don't want to deal with this business anymore. Other people ended up in jail because they escalated behind the scenes. And because of that, they're in jail now. Now they also have a record. Some communities fell into criminality and types of plagues because as a community, people were upset with you, but because they couldn't win from you, they couldn't shut you down, that anger turned into domestic violence against one another, and because of that, criminality increased, families broke apart. So in any case, things backfired, and they can't go back to before things backfired. And the reason things backfired was because they persisted in darkness against you. So they're now in a situation where they have to accept reality and they have to accept results and live with results they don't want. And because they don't want things to get worse, they come with a ceasefire. They'll stop acting out against you just to avoid things from becoming worse for them. That is what Isaac experienced when those people from Canaan came to him to make peace. It wasn't real peace, they just wanted a ceasefire. They did not want Isaac to rightfully take actions against them. Because they've lost their reputation, they've lost the trust of their people, and soon later will lose everything. So, a ceasefire is not peace. A ceasefire is simply that a warring party does not attack anymore because it's too costly for them to attack. That is all it is. So, a ceasefire is when the warring party has no other choice but to behave themselves. So, in a ceasefire, you will not experience any assaults or any attacks for a period of time. But don't be deceived. It is a ceasefire. It is not peace. People have not repented. They have not forfeited the fight against you. They have not forfeited their negative claims. They have not forfeited relief seeking. They haven't changed into responsible human beings that take responsibility and look for solutions. They haven't. They're still the same relief seekers, and many of them even became worse. They became full-blown narcissists. While things were backfiring, they kept persisting and it turned into reprobates. So many of them are either the same or they are worse than how they used to be. The only reason you don't experience all that violence now is because they have no other option because you're too exhausted by all the things that backfired on them. And here's the thing. The purpose of the ceasefire is for you to stop walking by faith. Because once you stop walking by faith, you're not operating God's protection anymore, and now, after a while, they will break the ceasefire and attack again. So a ceasefire is a forced shutdown of a warring party. And this shutdown is something they agree to just to prevent worse from happening to them. A capitulation is when a party, a warring party, gives up. They don't want to continue. But here's the difference. With a ceasefire, it's just because they have no other option. A ceasefire is as follows. If they had the chance, they would do it again and it would finish the job. But because they can't finish the job without killing themselves, they ceasefire. In capitulation, they just move away. They give up completely. Now, A capitulation in itself is not the end of a conflict. Because some reprobates, they capitulate and they flee. So they never have to face you or see you again, nor the people from their past. They've capitulated, so they're absolutely not coming after you anymore. But it's only because they don't want to face themselves. Because they are too frightened to even think about persisting in a conflict. But then you have people that capitulate and they surrender to Christ. So capitulation can be a sign of salvation on an individual level, but it can also be a sign of someone's doom. Just realize that a ceasefire is not peace. Some of you who are listening to this, you're going through a ceasefire season now. The demons are seeing that they'll embarrass themselves and they'll lose the trust of commoners if they keep operating against you. Why? Because you act wise as a serpent and innocent as a dove, as Christ told us to. Some people around you are realizing that if people keep on fighting you, they'll lose their minds, and when they lose their minds, they'll turn on them. So there are commoners around that experience this anger against you, and they can see clearly if people can't kill you, the homicidal anger of those people will turn on the community. So now those people will now have a problem with those people who are against you. Not because those commoners are for you, they're not for you. They may even secretly agree with those that oppose you, but because the homicidal anger of those that oppose you will harm them, they now turn on those that oppose you. Even if they secretly oppose you too, they do not want that homicidal rage to affect them and their families. So they may call for a ceasefire by dealing with those who are opposing you. But even that is not because they really want to comply with justice. It's just that they want danger to remove itself from them. It's just because they want relief from danger. That's it. They want relief from discomfort, so they comply with external demands for justice without actually complying with justice itself. That's what you need to understand. Complying with justice implies capitulating and forfeiting for good the fight against Christ. Complying with external demands of justice simply means that you stop doing some bad stuff just to avoid further repercussions. And that is what a lot of worldlings do. Just because they comply with external demands of justice, that doesn't mean they are complying with justice itself. Do not be deceived by a ceasefire. Because this is a trap where many believers go wrong. When a ceasefire occurs, they think it's all peace. No, it's not. They are too afraid to tell it to your face that they can't stand you. And they are upset because behind the scenes where they are meditating bitterness against you, it backfires. So they cannot express their anger against you because it's founded on relief seeking. There is no justification for their anger against you at all. And every attempt of them to look for justification shows how pathetic their attitude is. And once they lose their reputation, there is nothing left for them. And because of that, they're now avoiding you or fleeing from you or they become obsessed with pleasing you. Why? Because they are frightened of the repercussions that are haunting them. So never consider it a good sign when suddenly all people treat you very well. When suddenly everyone treats you very well, that's not a good sign. They should have been treating you that well from the start. Why do they suddenly do it? And why is it as if suddenly nobody dares to even think bad about you? It is because things are backfiring and they're desperate to shut you down. Because in a ceasefire, they admit they can't shut you down, so they tolerate your existence. Because they know they can't do anything about your existence. But don't be deceived. Any moment they see any opportunity to pick up the fight again, they will. They will. When they capitulate and flee from you, they will not come back, they will not hoover you, but the danger is still in existence. But because you walk by faith, you've shut down the danger and you are safe. That is the difference between the pagan and the believer. The pagan has relief from danger. We are delivered from evil. That is why worldlings prefer pagans above believers. Because with the pagan, deep down inside, they feel that they may still have a chance. And that's correct. Because once the paranormal charm expires, the pagan has to get another charm, or they'll have to perish by all the accumulated anger and opposition against them. With a believer that truly walks by faith, there is no chance anymore to dump their frustrations. There is no chance anymore to unload their bitterness. So it's either they capitulate at their own expense, which implies that they'll lose, and because they've lost, they can now finally win by submitting to Christ, or they persist and they have to capitulate into damnation. So they have no other option. So believers, understand that the war is playing out right now. The earth is in a state of war because of those that oppose Christ. And believers are the target in this war. Believers and worldly people that are vulnerable, they are the target. Now, worldly people that are vulnerable have the option to join believers or to perish. Well, actually, they don't have the option to perish. God never gave them the option, but they will perish if they don't join believers. Just realize that the war is working out now. And you need to understand it's a state of war that worldly people are in. Now, you are delivered from a state of war, but you're still affected by the war. That's why you need to be wise as a serpent and innocent as a dove. Do not confuse a ceasefire for a solution, because a ceasefire is not a solution. The only solution is when they forfeit. The only solution is when they capitulate their unexamined expectations, and when they forfeit the fight against Christ, which is the fight against reality, and they comply with justice. That's the only solution there is. If they're not doing that, there is no solution. So, keep agreeing with Christ and be at peace.